My dad is like, you know, he's the leader of the household. So when 9/11 happened, I was a sophomore in high school. My dad sits everybody down at the dinner table. And he's like, all right, Hasan, whatever you do, do not tell people you're Muslim. Do not talk about politics. And I was like, all right, dad, I'll just hide it. Cool. And this just rubs off. We're sitting there, phone rings. I run to the phone, but my dad, he had a good first step, so he beats me to the phone. He's like, dah, dah, hello? I grab the second phone, hello? And I hear a voice, hey! Hey, you sand nigger, where's Osama? He looks at me. You can hear me, right, you fucking dune coon? Where's Osama? He's just like, yabble. Hey, you can hear me, right? 263 Nergata Lane, that's where you live, right? I'm gonna fucking kill you, click. And my dad's looking at me. You ever see your parents and you see the mortality in them? Like, I'm looking at my dad and I see all 5'7" of him. And that's when I realized, no, I'm a dart book. I'm a scaredy cat. You know the way it is. We can speak two languages, garkibate, barkibate. We can speak at home and outside. I should have said something. I didn't. We sit down, I hear foom, foom, foom outside. So me and dad, we run outside and all the windows on the Camry are smashed in. And I look in the back and my backpack's open. I'm like, fuck, they stole my stuff. I reach and I pull out my backpack. These pieces of glass get caught in my arm. And now all this blood is like gushing down the side of my arm. And I'm pissed, I'm just like fucking mad. Man, fuck this, man. Like, these kids, they know where we live. They're calling us. They're timing this in real time, so they're watching us. So I'm running up and down the cul-de-sac, looking in the trees, the bushes. I look back in the middle of the street. My dad's in the middle of the road, sweeping glass out of the road like he works at like a hate crime barbershop. Just like, oh man, we got customers, low-key gang. We gotta clean this up. Zen, brown Mr. Miyagi, just like not saying a word. I run up to him like, dad, why aren't you saying something? I'm not asking you now, say something. He looks at me and he goes, Hasan, ye cheeze to hote? Or ye cheeze hoenge? These things happen, and these things will continue to happen. That's the price we pay for being here. And that's when I was like, oh no, we really are from two different generations. Like, BMX bikes aside. Like, my dad's from that generation, like a lot of immigrants, where he feels like if you come to this country, you pay this thing like the American dream tax, right? Like, you're gonna endure some racism, and if it doesn't cost you your life, well, hey, you lucked out, pay it. There you go, Uncle Sam. But for me, like a lot of us, I was born here. So I actually have the audacity of equality. Like, I'm like, nah, I'm an honors gov. I have it right here. Life, liberty, pursuit of happiness. All men are created equal. Says it right here. I'm equal. I'm equal. I don't deserve this. But I can't, as soon as I say that, and he looks at me like I believe in Santa. He's like, Hasan, don't come into my jacket. You'll never understand. I'll never understand. Dad, you're the guy that'll argue with the cashier at Costco when he doesn't let you return used underwear. And now you wanna be the bigger man? Now you're like, no, let's be reasonable with the bigots. What? And then he just walks back into the house with glass in his feet. And I honestly don't know who's more right. Like, maybe he's right. I don't know, put your head down, go be a doctor, get a house in the burbs, laugh later, let him call him, whatever you want. But then I'm like, wait, isn't it our job to like push the needle forward little by little? Isn't that how all this stuff happens? SCOTUS decision, then this, I don't know. The pendulum swings back and forth for me. And I know 9/11 is a super touchy subject. I understand, you know, because when it happened, everyone in America felt like their country was under attack. But on that night, September 12th, it was the first night of so many nights where I felt like my family's love and loyalty to this country was under attack. And it always sucks. As immigrants, we always have to put on these press releases to prove our patriotism. We're always auditioning and be like, yeah, we love this country, please believe me. Nobody loves this country more than immigrants. I love this country, man. I fell in love in this country. 6 years old, Janice Malo. I saw her in the sandbox. I run up to her, first grade. I was like, Janice, I love you. She's like, you're the color of poop. That's memory number one. Remember the first time you experienced racism? You don't know what it is. I was like, what? Oh no, it's not rubbing off. I was fucking terrified. It was like racist inception. There were so many levels to it. I just wanted to wake up in a bathtub like Joseph Gordon-Levitt and be like, oh, it's all a dream. I'm JGL, it was all a dream. But it's not a dream. It's the universe telling you, hey, it's a fair and lovely world. You gotta navigate accordingly. In the third grade, there was this assignment where Miss Anderson was like, hey, write what you want to be when you grow up. So some kids were like, I want to be an astronaut. Or like, I want to be a firefighter. And I was like, I want to be white. And she was like, honey, what do you mean? I was like, I want this part of my skin to be all of my skin. And it wasn't one of those weird things like, I hate melanin. It's not that. I love melanin. I've never gotten a sunburn. I'm hashtag blessed. But when you're white and you're playing the video game of life and your avatar comes out white, you just get asked less questions along the way at each level, right? Like you pop out, boom, I want to be Batman. Well, of course. Batman is white. Duh. Boom, I want to be president. Well, duh. 44 and a half presidents are white. We've had a great track record. And I know the privilege debate. I know the privilege debate is very heavy for white people. I know you guys have problems. I've seen Girls on HBO. I get it. But my dad did not give a shit about any of this identity stuff. Because he's an immigrant father. His rules with me growing up were very simple. No fun, no friends, no girlfriends. You can have fun in med school, which is a huge lie. It never gets popping in med school. I've never been to a club and seen like 9 dudes losing their mind. Like, yo, fellas, what's going on? What's going on? Residency, fam. No, never happens. I got a career I hate for my parents. It's a lie. We buy into it. I don't know why, right?